So I've been using Obsidian app for a while now, and this video is my honest and unbiased review on the Obsidian app. I'll cover all the main points, from key features to risks and considerations. So by the end of this video, you'll have a better understanding of the Obsidian app. One of the unique selling points of Obsidian is that it uses Markdown feature, a plain text format, which means your notes are stored as simple text files on your device. This is great because you have complete control over your data. Plus, this approach ensures your notes are accessible, transferable, and secure. And if security is a big concern for you, Obsidian offers end-to-end encryption for its sync feature, which is a major plus if you use the cloud sync option. One of the best features of Obsidian is its bidirectional linking. This might sound complicated, but it's actually quite simple. Imagine linking one note to another, and then being able to see that connection from both sides. It creates a network of your ideas, almost like a web, which can be really powerful for brainstorming or working on complex projects. Additionally, the graph view takes this a step further by visually mapping all your notes and connections, making it easier to see patterns or relationships you might not have noticed otherwise. Another area where Obsidian shines the most is its core set of plugins to enhance its functionality, like backlinks, canvas, and graph views. And it also offers community-made plugins for almost anything you can think of. From language-specific tools to productivity boosters, the options are endless. But let's be real, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. There are some cons to consider. For instance, Obsidian doesn't have a web version, which can be a deal-breaker if you need to access your notes from a browser on a public computer. Plus, while it's free for personal use, commercial users will have to shell out around $50 per year, and the cost goes up if you want premium features like Publish or Obsidian Sync. Another downside is that Obsidian relies entirely on Markdown, which might be a learning curve if you're used to rich text formatting. There's no drag-and-drop image insertion or fancy text styles. So, if you're not into Markdown, this can feel a bit restrictive. Overall, Obsidian is a solid choice if you're after a highly customizable, secure, and feature-rich note-taking app, and don't mind a bit of a learning curve with Markdown. Well, that's all for this video. I hope you found this video helpful. And if you did, make sure you give this video a super thanks by clicking on this heart icon to help support the channel, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button. We'll see you in the next one.